Hello everyone. This is the next lesson about applications of equation of motion. During last lessons, we derived the most general form of equation of motion and we used it in projectile motion. When we throw the body vertically, upward or downward, or diagonally at some angle to the horizontal. We also used equation of motion in uniform motion. In this task, we are throwing a body horizontally at the height h. We assume that frame of reference connected with the surface of Earth is inertial frame of reference, and then we can replace force of gravity by weight. We also assume that there is no resistance, so the front body is moving the same as in the vacuum. We know from the second Newton's law of motion that acceleration vector is directed the same as resultant force. In this case, the only acting force is force of gravity, and it is directed downward, so the same is directed acceleration vector. Also from the second Newton's law of motion, we can calculate magnitude of acceleration vector. It is magnitude of weight divided by mass. Weight is equal mass times g. G is gravitational acceleration, so m times g divided by m. M cancels, and we have the result that magnitude of acceleration vector is equal to g, to gravitational acceleration. In this task, we want to know where the front object will hit the obstacle. This obstacle can be a horizontal platform, vertical wall, or a slope. Equation of a platform is y equals to b, if here is b. Equation of vertical wall is x equals to c, if here is c. Equation of a slope is y equals tangent beta, this is this angle, times x. The method, this method is simple. We want to write equation of the path of the front body in the coordinate system yx, and we'll write equations of describing the obstacle, this, this, or this, and we'll try to find the place of intersection of these two lines. To write equation of the path of the front body, we'll write equation of motion for the axis x and equation of motion for the axis y. Let's start with the equation of motion for the axis x. Here I wrote the most general form of equation of motion. Here we have to know the meaning of x0, v0, and a. So I remind you that x0 is coordinate of initial position, v0 is coordinate of initial velocity vector, and a is coordinate of acceleration vector. I should also remind you that coordinate of vector is equal to plus magnitude of vector if vector is directed the same as axis, or minus magnitude of vector if the vector is opposite to the axis. So we should remember that that x0, v0 and a can be positive or negative. It is very important to draw velocity vector and acceleration vector, because otherwise we wouldn't know if v0 or a are positive or negative. So let's start to write equation of motion for the axis x. We see that coordinate of initial position on the axis x of the front body is zero. So x zero is equal to zero. The body has velocity in the direction of the axis x, it is v0, and v0 is directed the same as axis x, so coordinate of this vector is equal to plus magnitude of this vector, so here we have plus v0, so x equals plus v0 times delta t. We see that in the direction of the axis x there is no acceleration, because there is no force acting in this direction. So acceleration vector does not have component in the axis x, so it is equal zero. So equation of motion for the axis x is just x equals v0 times delta t. Now we can write equation of motion for the axis y. We see that coordinate of initial position on the axis y is equal to h. So here is h. There is no velocity in the direction of axis y at the beginning. So v0 is equal to zero in this case. So this expression is also equal to zero, and there is acceleration in the direction of the axis y, but acceleration vector is directed is opposite to the axis y, so its coordinate is equal to minus magnitude of this vector. Magnitude of acceleration is equal to g, so here we have minus g. We can write equation of motion for the axis y. Y equals to h minus g times delta t squared divided by 2. So we have these two equations of motion, and we want to find the equation of the path of the front body in the coordinate system y x. So we have to get rid from these two equations delta t. We'll transform this first equation and calculate from it delta t. It's done here. Next, we put right side of this equation here. It's done here, and change form to such. So now we have equation of the path of the front body in the coordinate system y x. Now, to find the place where the front body hit the obstacle, we should add to this equation describing the obstacle. Let's start with the horizontal platform. Equation of this line is y equals to b. So it's enough to put instead of y, b, and calculate from this equation the value of x.
Of course, we should take this expression to the left side.
There will be plus in front of this equation, this expression on the left side, and b we put to take to the right side. It will be minus b here. So we have a quadratic equation, and this equation has a solution only if h is greater than b, because x squared is positive, so this difference h minus b also has to be positive. Of course, if h is greater than b, and the difference between h and b is greater than zero, then we'll have two solutions, one positive and one negative. This negative solution is the point where this line, it is parabola, is crossed by this straight line. Then this positive solution is the solution we are looking for. If b equals to zero, then equation of the obstacle is y equals to zero. It is equation of the axis x, and coordinate x of this point will be just the range, the distance, distance in the horizontal direction from the point of throwing the body. So, if y equals to zero, we put here zero, and then x equals to distance, this distance. So we put here d, and we calculate d from this equation. We change side of this expression to the left side, and calculate d. We here also have two solutions, and only the positive solution is the one we are looking for. We know that in the direction of the axis x, no force is acting on the body, so this body is moving in this direction with a constant speed v0. So distance d is equal to v0 times delta t. We calculated this distance here, and comparing these two equations, we see that delta t is equal to this square root. So we calculated also the time of the motion of this body. If our obstacle is vertical wall, its equation is x equals to c, then just put here c, and we calculate value of coordinate y of this place. If our obstacle is a slope, so its equation is y equals to tangent beta times x. So we put here tangent beta times x. It's done here, and we change side of these two expressions to the left side.
and we have here, and we have a quadratic equation, and we calculate roots of this equation, and the greater root is the value of coordinate x of the place where these two lines cross, intersect of this point.
So we have solved our problem, and it's the end of this lesson.